and that's the situation.
Oh, it just starts. Good morning, good afternoon, and a good evening to you all. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Devil May Cry 4. You are here with Morris at the end of the last part. Well, we've just been that guy, the guy with the crazy hair. Although that doesn't narrow it down. But the one with the crazy hair and the stutter, that's who we beat. Whoa! Okay. It's a little early. It's a little early for that. Where I am. Good to know we're back in the land of DMC4. I'm gonna shut up while we watch this.
It's your fault. It's your responsibility.
Credo.
Yes, Your Holiness.
Can you apprehend this boy?
You know, if you have a keen ear, or you like Naruto, you'll know that actually the voice of the well, you don't call him the Sage. What's he called? His Holiness. I mean, they only really refer to him as His Holiness. The guy with the big hat in the throne. That's actually Liam O'Brien, who's in a lot of different things. You know, you don't have to just know Naruto, but yeah. It took me a while to realize that. I remember when I first, because I don't like to, sometimes I don't like to look it up. I like to go through the torture of, I don't know who that guy is and it's killing me, but I'm going to sit here and work it out. Even if it kills me.
But she remains almost a stranger to us all.
Which will only concern.
Yeah, no, I can't think why they let her in. Can't think why this creepy old man let someone like that into his organization. Can't think of. There must be at least two good reasons why she was let in.
Find us Nero and Yamato.
Don't touch me.
Back to me.
As you wish, Your Holiness.
Oh, he's got his main man on the job now.
That menace, Nero, appears to be quite close to Credo's sister, Kyrie.
Oh, just slipping that in there. Why is the name Kyrie following me everywhere? It's in Project Zero and it's here as well. Although it's less threatening, but still a problem. Alrighty, well, I guess now we're properly back into it. I totally forgot about that scene. I'm so used to skipping through the scenes, I forgot that was even there. But hey, now we're into it. This is what I was expecting to see. Why don't we start again? Good morning, good afternoon, and a good evening to you all, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to DMC4. You are here with Morris. Yeah, it's been a little while since I played this. Boy, have I had a lot on at the moment. Since I started work, I have been completely just knackered every single day. It's great. No, weekdays, you know, it's very tough. But I've actually been busy pretty much every weekend since I started as well. Like, all day, every day. I haven't had a lie-in for weeks. Which is a real shame for someone like me, who appreciates that kind of thing. But boy, am I glad to be playing DMC4 again, after what feels like forever, because, you know, I enjoy Project Zero, and it was interesting and fun, and, you know, there's memories there. But at the same time, I had to think about that game. I had to think long and hard about certain things. You know, I had to do a lot of editing for all the times that I messed up, which was a lot, in case you didn't see it. It was a lot of times. But this one, I'm not even thinking. I don't even need to think. Who cares, right? I can just sit here. I don't even need to look at what I'm looking at right now. I can just look away. I can take a walk through the house. This controller's wireless. I don't need to be in the room to play this game. I know it that well. You know? It's not an ego thing. It's just a, you know, countless hours spent in my room playing it kind of thing. Which is less cool, actually. Oh, that's good tea. And I'm really doing my best here to just not immediately skip every scene. Even these little ones don't really mean too much. Oh, these enemies. Yeah, so those, I forget what they're called, but those things that wrap the little vine tentacle things around the regular enemies, they, generally make everything a lot more deadly. I mean, these scarecrow versions aren't that bad, but, yeah, they don't limit themselves to the scarecrows. Oh god, because of that. They can just throw out that move whenever they want. But the thing is, think about these guys. The beautiful thing about these guys is that they're actually very, very weak to, as you can see right there, they're very weak again to the charge shot, which is just making another fine appearance as the most powerful thing anyone has ever put in a game, I think. It's just... it's crazy. But yeah, very, very very extremely useful against these guys. I don't need to charge up anymore, do I? But yeah, I had to think a lot about, long and hard about Project Zero, and I had to do a lot of editing with it, and, you know, there was a lot of stop-start stuff, because, I'd like to say, I just started work, but, you know, this one, there isn't really any of that. I can just play and play and play, over and over and over. And I love it for that. I can just relax. This is relaxing. This is a relaxing playthrough for me. I don't get many of those, you know? It's like a little holiday for me, this one. Welcome. Welcome to the Devil May Cry Resort. You know, what I like about this game as well, as you can see, we're in a very sort of different environment to what you'd not necessarily expect, but to what we've been used to so far. And that's one of the things about this game is, well, Devil May Cry games generally, is you can just do anything and go anywhere, and it's like, who cares? You know, it's just, it's like, oh, demons. Demons did that. What you're looking at right now, that was demons. That was probably demons. That was almost definitely the demons. You know, they're the reason for everything, so you can just pretty much create whatever kind of environment you want, you know? And this forest area, it looks beautiful. It looks pretty. It's got a lot of god rays coming in here from pretty much, oh god, from pretty much everywhere. From pretty much, oh god, yeah, no, that would be accurate, god rays. But yeah, that's one of the things I like about this game. And you know, I mean, alright, I'm not expecting everybody out there to have done a film degree. I'm sorry, I'm one of those people. But, I don't know, you'll probably, if you're into games or into films, those are the two main things I think that this applies to. But if you're into either of those two, and you kind of, you have a friend who also likes games and films, but whenever they suggest, like, a game or a film, and you play it, and you don't think it's that good, they always assume it's because, oh, well, I mean, the example I'm going to talk about applies to films, you know? Some people don't like watching films with me because they think, oh, he did a film degree, he's going to be all uppity about it, you know, he's going to think he knows everything. So if I don't like a film, it must be for some insanely complex reason which nobody can fathom. It must be so theoretical, so in-depth, but it's not. Sometimes I just don't like a film because it's, you know, it's not believable. And you know, people say to me, I mean, I've had this kind of argument before, is that people say to me, well, films, you know, they're supposed to be escapism, right? It's supposed to, you know, you just watch and it just happens and who cares, right? It's like, well, yeah, that's fine. You know, use it for escapism. I have done enough and I still do, and games are part of that, right? But if I don't believe the world that I'm looking at, if I don't believe that what's happening is even possible inside the world that we're watching, how the hell am I supposed to escape to it? You know? What do you want from me? I'm only human. And so I'm naturally going to ask questions. I can't just sit there and watch and just, you know, go at the end of it, go, yeah, that was fine. You know, it's like, no. That's the difference between a good and a bad movie. Do I believe what's happening? It doesn't matter if it's stupid, unbelievable, would never happen kind of situation like this. None of this would ever happen, right? But I believe it within the world of the game itself, you know? Look at this. Look at these SS combos. Beautiful. I'm not even thinking about it. I'm just... It's all muscle memory at this point. But that is important with a game like this. But yeah, I'm sure I'm not the only one to have a conversation like that. But yeah, I hate it when people say, oh, well, you know, you did film, so you just, you know, you don't like whatever. It's like, if you studied something, you must be a critic, you know? It's like, no, maybe I just don't like certain things that you like. I understand that must be hard for you, but... Oh, how did I not get that? Oh, how did I not get that through again? Oh, whoa, okay, I was thinking that was going to be a third time, but we're okay. Oh, I'm glad that we have this with us. I love these things, they're so overpowered. They're so unnecessarily overpowered. Don't you like weapons like that? Come on, Nero, do the business. Right there. Making quick work of those guys. But yeah, I guess this level is meant to be a bit more maze-like. Certainly later on, it's very, very maze-like. To an unfair degree. But I've always liked this level aesthetically. And I like the variance in the levels in this game. Boy, that frame rate seemed really bad on that creature there. Just for a second when it was in the background. Oh, and again, that tongue. Whoa, what is wrong with the tongue there? Alrighty, so this section should be really spooky and like, oh no, what's gonna happen? But if you have the sprint move, which you will almost definitely have, it's trivial. Just trivial. I think in the original sprint, did it cost more? No, I don't think it cost more, but it didn't trigger quite as quickly. It's one of the... I think I might have mentioned it already. You know what? It's been so long, I can't even remember. But the sprint actually triggers a lot quicker. Normally, you'd run about that far, and then the sprint would actually trigger. But you can see it triggers instantly now, which I think is a big improvement, because I didn't like having to wait for it to trigger. Because I'm impatient like that, especially when playing this. But yeah, it's a... Whoa. Okay, who else is spawning here? Who else is... Whoa, okay. Alright, I see. I see what the plan is here. Oh, beautiful. Smoke and star. I can't get that triple S just now. Hmm. Oh, that's good to see. I need that. I've actually only really just got in from work. I'm relaxing right now. This is being relaxing. Alright, what do you got for me, Demon Gate? Yeah, that'll do it, Nero. That'll do it. Just punch wildly on the outside of it. That's how you defeat enemies. Whoa! Oh! Sorry. Oh, don't do that. Just gonna be really pissed. Oh yeah, sexy lady inside there. Always gotta have a, you know, a weirdly hot demon in these Devil May Cry games. Weirdly hot boss demon, you know. It's like a trope. Also, why is she complaining about her children if she just basically threw them at me? Like, who throws a child at someone and then says, "Whoa, don't hit the child." Like, what am I supposed to do? Just catch it? Or just let it hit me? Like, what do you want from me? Whoa! I do like this boss. I think I like it more because it's kind of easy. When you know what you're doing. But you can have really good runs or really bad runs with this boss. Very, there's no way I can predict how this is really going to go, to be honest. Can I get another one of those? No. Sometimes she... I don't know about the, like, set patterns, really, but sometimes this boss will just give you... will just do the moves that you really want her to do. And she'll stagger easy, and it'll just be a party all day, every day. That kind of swivel move is pretty... not tough to dodge, but kind of annoying when she does it. But yeah, if you can stagger it during these phases, you get some really freaking good hits in. This one especially, where you just basically ride it, for lack of a better term. That's the one you want. Yeah. See, that went really well. That was just a really nice run. Because she has different phases, but the fact is it takes her a while to get to them. And it takes her a while to... she has a little, you know, power-up animation and everything. So if you just keep hammering away, you can kind of skip through the phases almost. My god, that's a big arm. You know, Nero, I don't know if anyone told you, but women don't like it when you just grab their butt like that. Hey, don't step up if you're not gonna. At least, you know, don't do it out of the blue, you know.
Didn't your mom ever tell you not to litter?
Nero, they can't even hear you. Why are you still spouting off the witty lines? There's not even any need for. Oh, I got a triple S on that one as well. The Sephirothic fruit. One of Echidna's seeds. This fruit of her womb holds the power that binds together demonic plants. It's basically a fancy word for this is a key. This is a rusty-ass key that will get you through whatever the hell. Just another random item that unlocks progress, basically. Can't argue with that. So, of course, there are areas in this level that have been blocked off by that. But when you know where to go, you don't encounter them. But now that we've got that, we can go back through the level and unlock the rest of it. Another S rank, I'll take it. I'll take it all day. No complaints here, I'll take that. Mmm. God, that tea is sublime. Profession of faith. Embrace the light to escape the forest. It's an awfully grand way of saying just get the hell out of there. Oops, sorry, I'm just mashing buttons. That's a nice... Well, that used to be a really nice shot, but I don't know what the hell is wrong with this version, but it just seems stupidly bright all of a sudden. I don't know if anyone noticed that. But that used to be a nice sort of location shot. It's like, hey, this is where you're going to go. Look forward to this bit, dude. Yeah, it's happening. Oh, yeah. That's what you mean. So, yeah. You'll notice that these little bastards here, they kind of wander around. They don't necessarily attack you. When there are other enemies around, they're much more likely to attack the enemies themselves, grab hold of them, and then turn them into a more powerful version of themselves. So if you get into a situation where everything's spawning individually, it's much... Oh, here we go. This is what you need. So if you get into a situation where you have a lot of the little buggers wandering around, it's always, always better to take them out first. No exceptions. I mean, we're on normal, so it's not really a massive deal. Actually, it's more of a thing in Bloody Palace, because the amount of those things that are in the Bloody Palace is unbelievable. It's probably why they call it the Bloody Palace, I guess, but... Oh my. Pooch. Don't you come near me. Well, it's not even a pooch, is it? I don't even know what it is. Some, like, Halo enemy or something. But I like how they have little bucklers on the side. That's cool. I don't know, it's not like a stupid, overpowered shield. Just a little mini one. Because, you know, the maneuverable guys, they don't want to be weighed down by that shit. But yeah, these guys do block you. And can parry you, I believe. Again, maybe not on this difficulty, but it's worth knowing. Just in case it does come up. Oh, and they shoot seeds. Did I mention how annoying that was? As that will come out of nowhere. Almost exclusively come out of nowhere. Oh, yeah. Can't handle a charge, baby. Can't handle a charge. You can try. Not happening, though. Again, very deadly in numbers. More than anything. If you're playing on the... Legendary Dark Knight, and you get a load of those, you are in trouble. At least initially. Gotta wear those guys down. Alrighty, back through here, because there was another door. I didn't even look at it before, did I? Again, it's meant to be maze-like, but not really. It's just... Some stuff is blocked off, but hey, the game is telling me. That my fruit... Oh, you hid those, didn't you, in the little cutscene? But yeah... The fruit is telling me that I can now open that way up. So that's very nice. That's very generous. Oh, that was nice. You'll notice that my style of play does not really change, despite you can introduce whatever new enemy you want. The moves that I use work on literally everything. That's why I use them. So it might be simplistic, but boy is it efficient. That is basically my personal ad right there. Simplistic but efficient. Ooh, spawn these again. I'll take them. Oh yeah, that's a nice freeze frame there. Yeah, you'll notice the red ones, obviously, we can't break those. Because we wear blue. That's it. No, it's because we're not Dante. Only Dante may break those. We know what that does. And it reveals a door. Aha! What might this room be with its fancy camera angles? Shall we have a read? This is a gentle forest, yet those who treat her unkindly will fall into darkness. Those who do not wish for darkness, that we just mentioned prior to this, should seek the light, for if not, all efforts will be in vain. You can barely read that text on the white floor there. Basically, that just means head towards the light, and you might go, well, I can't go upwards, what the fuck's that about? No, it just means head towards where the light is coming from. And you can tell that because of the shadows here. It's very simplistic. It's one of those things that, you know, it got me at first, because I was like, where the hell? It was just trial and error, you know? But once you know it, you go, oh yeah, it's one of those things, you feel really stupid when, as soon as you get it. And if you go the wrong way, if you go into the darkness, you just get transported to a little arena, you gotta fight a few enemies, and then you come out and do it again. So, it's not that punishing, but if you have to, if you trial and error it all the way through, yeah, you could be doing that, you know, about 10 times, so you don't want to be, well, maybe not 10, but quite a few. Like how the camera isn't it? The camera's not even bothering to follow me there. I was just fighting off camera. See, this game, it just assumes I know what I'm doing. You know? I like that. Yeah. You know, that charge shot is so good. How many times can you say charge shot in one episode? I don't know. But it's so good that I'm much more likely to use this over using the Buster. Because the Buster does a lot of damage quickly, but just the fact that the charge shot delays its second attack, and the second attack normally stuns an enemy or takes it out of whatever attack, you know? It's just so useful. It's way more useful than the Buster, I think. Especially if you want to keep fighting, you don't want to get locked into any kind of lengthy kicking the shit out of someone animation. Which is, you know, you can have those. You can have as many of those as you want. But when you're trying to speed through it, yeah, just shoot them. Hi, Credo. We're friends, right? Sure seemed that way at the beginning of the game. Kind of.
That's a look you shoot your enemy.
Also, who told you that beard looked good?
Okay. Well, then let me ask you this. What exactly is the Order after? And who the hell is Dante? You do not demand answers from me!
Okay, that seems like an overreaction. A little bit, a little bit tightly wound today, aren't we, Credo?
I don't want to hurt you. I won't do that to Kyrie. Hurt me? You don't get it, do you? You too.
Oh yeah, no, they all been drinking that juice, baby. I really like how his demon form enhances his beard. Like, why would it do that?
You become as a demon.
There is no need for that. But I do think his design looks super fucking cool, by the way. I don't want to take anything away from Credo. He looks awesome like this. Also, is it a coincidence that we got a Sephirothic fruit and now we're fighting a guy with one wing? Like, I don't know. Draw your own conclusions from that. So this fight is probably my worst. It's not too bad at the beginning. But I'm not 100% on how to kind of go through all the phases. I don't want to give you any bad advice here. All I can say is just do your best to kind of use the buster attack, sure. Oh god. Yeah, use the buster attack, sure. Get the shield down. Hammer away at him like this. But that's pretty much the only advice I have. You can see how much damage that does. But, can we get another one in? But all these combos can get pretty, pretty intense, certainly later on. And this might look like it's really easy, but, oh god. Okay, you can throw those back to him, but I don't necessarily recommend it. The timing has to be, it's one of the most precise timing things in the game. Those spears that he throws at you. I actually don't think that charge shot is doing anything. Gosh darn. Oh, there we go. He's probably... Yeah, it's not too bad on normal. But on the harder difficulties, my god, that shield takes fucking forever to go down. You have to grab him, like, between 5 or 10 times a day. And obviously you're not doing anywhere near as much damage, unfortunately. Dude, you lasted like 2 minutes, if that.
Your strength has increased.
Oh no, this is not what it looks like. Where did you come from, also? I wish you'd shown up a few minutes earlier. You could have talked him out of fighting me.
No, wait. This isn't what you think.
Why? He could just wing it. He could just be like, oh no, what happened to my arm? I must be possessed. But now I've snapped out of it now.
It was our intentions to protect you from the truth.
Also, where did you come from?
Not to worry. I have no intentions of harming her.
I feel like Kyrie is a bit thick to not realize who the bad guys are in this situation.
It would appear.
Especially now.
She has nothing to do with this. Let her go!
Agnus!
How dare you use my sister?
Oh, that wasn't part of the deal. Oh no, his Bugman form. Oh man, if only I had some kind of grab attack that I could use to pull him out of the sky. Oh well, no, now he's a bit out of reach. I'll give him that. Why is everyone here around here so stupid?
Back to headquarters!
I'd assume so. Nero, we must set aside this battle until I find out the truth of this.
Yeah, no, that form is wicked. I love that. Plus, I like this whole area. I mean, I guess we'll see more in the next level, but... Aegis Shield. Shield once held by Credo. Those who take it up will find a new source of power, which we're not going to tell you about. And it is not at all obvious what that is, but we'll get to it. Alrighty, and a fully charged sword for some reason. And that is the end of the level. I don't know why they didn't end the level in the cutscene. They make you take a few steps forwards for some reason. Ah, anyway, what's that? SSB? That's not great. Come on, we can do better than that. Alrighty, well, I'm gonna have to pause it for now, guys. But thank you very much for watching this episode of Devil May Cry 4. Yes, we are back with Devil May Cry 4. Thank the Lord that we're back. But yeah, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you're looking forward to the rest of it. We get right stuck in now, because the levels are going to get more and more intense as we go on, as I'm sure you can tell. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and I hope to see you in the next part. See you in a bit.